go through some risk factors that can contribute to ADHD. And I'm gonna have both of you interject here. Genes, cigarette smoking, alcohol use or drug use during pregnancy, exposure to environmental toxins during pregnancy, exposure to environmental toxins at young age, low birth weight, and brain injuries. Joanna, I know you want to add a few more, but Martin, talk to me about those real quick, and then Joanna, you add the couple more that you want to.
So the relationship between genes and behavior, it's always a complex relationship, rather between genes and the environment. We do know that there's definitely a genetic component and a component that if one of your parents happens to have ADHD, you're much more likely to have ADHD. So we do know that's the case. We also know things such as low birth weight, socioeconomic status, and that can put you in situations where you happen to be exposed to different chemicals that could have an effect on the development of the brain and therefore the development of ADHD. Furthermore, we know there are also brain injuries.
And Joanna, you wanted to add a couple more to the list. Mm-hmm. What are they and can you explain them?
Of course. To piggyback on a couple of things he said, with the low birth weight and the socioeconomic status, when you see low birth weight, development starts a lot, you know, it takes longer, you know?
Sure.
And so they're not developing at a normative rate. And then with socioeconomic status, one of the main things in terms that he mentioned, in terms of that, low socioeconomic status means that there are fewer resources available to those families, yep. Or they do not have the time because they're busy working to maintain those basic needs.